So Sham, I really want to implement all these new methods, all these new things I'm learning from everywhere on the web, but it's just not me. It's just not me. Hi, this is Sham, the responsible restaurant owner, and we're going to cover the challenge that lots of restaurant owners are having to implement new processes in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. So here is the challenge. You want to get better. So this is step number one, and you made it. So congratulations. Option number two is that you want to implement these new processes, but it just doesn't feel like it's you. You know, the wording is weird, the method is weird, I've been doing it for such a long period of time. How can I implement these new changes? And this video is to let you know that one, it is possible, and two, it's just going to take time for it to become second nature. It's like learning anything new. The first part is that you're going to start doing it in a robotic format. You know, you're just gonna be repeating words and implementing systems, and it's not gonna make a lot of sense maybe to you at the beginning, but you have to trust the process. Here is the main thing, guys. You need to be able to relate to and follow the directions of somebody you can relate to. Lots of people, and myself included, have done the mistake when I first opened the restaurant, listening to so many different people at the same time. They all had very good tips, but you need to stick to one person as a way to have the big picture. What do I mean by the big picture? Everybody out there is giving you little pieces of a puzzle. And I really do believe that if you want to be successful, you need to stick with one picture. Stick to it for at least 1 year before you even judge it or question it. The person who was able to give you this information should be reachable for you to ask questions. And I do know lots of us restaurant owners want sometimes do the shortcut to save money, but there is no shortcuts in actually turning your restaurant into a successful operation, especially if you are hurting right now. Find somebody that you can trust, a mentor, and stick to their plan. Ask them questions, challenge your authority, find out where they are, what have they accomplished. And once you establish that relationship of trust, go for it. So step number one is you're going to be doing it like a robot. You're going to be like, oh my gosh, but you know, these words are not mine and it's not my vocabulary and I've never done this. Should I really do that? Keep on and do that. First step is doing it robotic. Second step, you're going to start to become more comfortable. You know, you're going to be able to relate to it, you know, and it's going to feel like, oh, now I understand why we say this and why we do this. Now it's going to make more sense. You, boss, are super busy. For you to really implement and absorb a complete new methodology over the course of a week or two is just not possible. Besides, if your brain is like moving at a speed beyond the speed that any human brain is moving. So I'm going to assume that we are of me first, of simple intelligence, and you know, and I'm just so busy with other things. So the second part, as I said, is that you're going to start to feel a little bit more comfortable. Things are going to start to make a little bit more sense. And third step, that's when the fun starts. That's when you start actually adding your own personal touches to this processor. That's when it's going to become from being a mold that you have used to reach success, you're going to actually give it your own personal twist. So if you are getting frustrated by implementing new methods, guess what? It is perfectly normal, and that is called the learning curve. My recommendation, once again, and I always repeat it, stick to one instructor. By taking different pieces of different puzzles from different pictures, guess what? It's going to end up being a mess. You need to start from the basics. There is no reason to work on changing your menu if your servers don't even know how to talk about your food. There is no reason to actually have your servers talk about food if you don't know what their purpose is. What is the purpose of these waiters coming and working for you? Are they there for internship? Are they there for short-term, long-term? So it all starts with the proper onboarding process. You can hear that a lot. I believe in that. Whoever tells you that you need to stick to a good onboarding process has a good philosophy in mind, but people just want to start with changing your website and having you jump through all these expensive hoops, you know, slow your horses down. You have to start with the basics, and the basic character ingredient, the supreme ingredient in your operation is you, my friend. So that was my little take on how you can implement new strategy. Thank you so much for being being out there trying to get yourself better. You know, we do need more successful restaurants out there, more small and medium family style restaurants kicking butts. Yes, sorry for my English, but that was the word I said. I really believe as professionals, we have done a horrible job as promoting the hospitality industry as an attractive career, and we need to change that. Once again, this was me, Sham, the responsible restaurant owner. Please do comment. This is what makes this page exciting and interactive. If I've said anything wrong, guess what? It happens to me quite a bit. So correct me, make suggestions. Sorry for the thick accents. I don't think my accent is going to change anytime soon. And remember, the secret ingredient is love.